31 seconds, and we're going for auto sequence start.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in this court of music. If you give up that right, you have a right to an attorney.
Welcome to the ULI podcast, a podcast dedicated to calling out your friends' bullshit. I'm Brian.
You nigga J Will, aka J Money.
And it's your favorite piehead, Sir D's, in the middle of taking my sip of this bomb ass cognac one time, feeling real good in the building.
And unlike any other week, we are obviously missing somebody. Your boy Chris,
Chris, man, he here in spirit with us, man.
Life hits you gotta handle it. So yeah, that's what he's doing right now.
Yep. Taking care of
up until then, we gonna, you know, we I don't do this intro thing. So what does he normally do? He lists out the, you know, we
other week.
Come on, you know, thank you. Come on, here we go.
With the topics that we've been seeing and shit that been affecting our lives and stuff on the daily this week, you know, we and if any of us sense any bullshit,
we're going to call it out.
Each other out. He does the flash, the ULI,
Cash App, the shot.
The Jamaican Me Ready push-ups. We're botching Chris's delivery completely, but it's okay.
Come back and fix it, bro. Botching the fuck out of you.
All right. Just like every other week, we're going to hit you with the fresh topics and stuff. And anytime we hear some bullshit, you know, we're going to call out our boys. And if we are caught up in a bullshit, you know, those call outs come with it. Just like any other week, we bringing you the hottest topics that we found on our timelines that affect our daily lives. Calling each other out whenever we smell some bullshit. And you know, those call outs come with the penalties, the dreaded push-ups, the Jamaican Me Ready push-ups, the $10 Cash App to 805 Entertainment. You know, sometimes help y'all us. Niggas, yep. Y'all be wrong too.
Or the much more dreaded one shot.
The shots. That has become the most dreaded.
It is.
Real dreaded, bro. That's
so, yeah, so we got a fresh new, you know, fresh new content, good show for y'all, you know, keeping our brother Chris in our thoughts. He's still here in spirit. So with that being said, let's get to it.
All right. KD, Kevin Durant, your boy, Mr. Sensitive himself. You know, I woke up this morning. Was it this morning or yesterday morning? It was the one morning. I think it might have been yesterday morning. And I see a tweet from KD basically saying, like, you know, Bam decided to practice his dribble after I green beaned, you know, the shot with the ball, blah, 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 basically saying that he didn't get his change back from Bam. And then you click on it and you see this. And we'll pull up the clip right now.
Come on, Brian, bring it in.
All right. So we saw that. I brought it in. So yeah, y'all saw the clip. You know, KD makes it, and apparently, you know, it was Bam who picked up his ball. You can't see it in the shot, but I mean, you know who shot. You shot it. You track your ball.
Yeah.
You know who picked up the ball. Yeah. Whatever. Bam. Hey, bro, Bam picked up the ball.
Hey, bro, I need that.
And and he just started dribbling and walking away. Well, here's the problem. He didn't stay on the perimeter and. Bam, what you doing?
Yeah.
He didn't stay there. That's not that. That's what. So he took the moment to register the fact that he didn't get the change. So he's sitting there on the perimeter. He makes a shot, and then Bam grabs the ball and dribbles and walks away. That is basketball 101. You do not grab somebody's change and start dribbling and shoot around. You don't do that.
It went through the hoop. Oh, he made it. All right, bet.
Give it back to him. Yeah, and the other dude, if you do not follow that etiquette, what does the dude that made the shot do? Give me my change.
That's it.
Yeah. Usually from the spot you shot it.
You're not moving.
I didn't even realize KD had shot a shot because he was already under the basket.
So he was down at the goddamn block.
Yeah.
So, Bam.
I thought he was kicking out the passes back.
Yeah.
So Bam gives him. Bam takes. You know, he basically takes. You know, start dribbling the ball. Whatever. Bam fucking around with the ball. And KD looks at him and like walks down toward the basket. And then, and then this is the problem. And then says something to Bam. Hey, I do blah 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 blah. Like, you know, this wasn't a very long clip, so it's not really that big, but it didn't make news, so we're going to break it down news, anyway. Yeah. It just in the moment,
news.
Because people caught it on camera, then KD had to do what? Put it on Twitter, yeah, because he's Instagram. Kevin Durant. He had to put it on Twitter because
he was
worried about how he looked in front of everybody. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I mean, y'all can take it from here. I can blather on.
Wait, what did he say on Twitter?
He's mad.
Yeah, he basically was just talking about Bam, yeah. And he sarcastically was like, Bam decided to practice his dribble after our green bean his jumper. You know,
okay, bro, you made the shot. Okay, but you didn't get the ball back. Like, hey, bro, I made the shot. Get back.
Hey, from
don't go to the block and wait. Mm-hmm. See, that's where you fucked up. At. You already waited. Now it's done. The situation's done with now. Bam got the ball. Whatever, he dribbling and shit. Whatever. I mean, it's basketball. Go ahead and give him the shot back, whatever. But you ain't got to put the motherfucker on social media talking about, man, you that's disrespectful to me. You need to learn some etiquette. And Bam's like, man, you trying to little brother me, bro. What you mean? Why are you putting shit on social media, bro? It's a practice shot.
It just don't matter. It's not.
It does not matter, bro.
It just show you how much he was worried about how he looked on the court right there.
Crazy, dude.
How much he was worried about that.
Or how he looked on camera.
Well, Bam should have said, you should have made that shot against the Milwaukee Bucks over here while you over here messing around. Making shots over here.
Ah, you petty.
You should have made that same shot against the Bucks. He would have been in the finals.
Whew. Yeah, yeah.
Boy, but now he over here with me practicing.
Well, here's the better question is why, when KD made that shot, did Bam not give it back?
Bam was looking at it, the situation like me, where I didn't see, from looking at the clip, I didn't see the energy of I just made a shot.
At all.
So as a nigga, when I was playing basketball, I always was a 4 or 5. I never was the jump shot, hit the jumper from three shooter type nigga. But if it was warm-ups and I made a jump shot anywhere around the court, nigga, I stood there and, hey, yeah, that's mine.
That's me. At least raise your hand
right
up.
Here. Mm-hmm. I never ran to the basket and something. Got under there and started passing everybody else their ball back.
Yeah.
As I'm waiting for the ball that I fucking made.
After you see someone made the shot. Someone made the shot, so you're looking for who made it. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Even niggas that don't see me make it, I'm, hey, no, I made that right here, cuz. I made that. Mm-hmm.
Like I said, raise your hand.
Yeah.
That's just something. How it is.
Yeah, that's how
if
it is.
If I run under the basket and I start passing the ball to other people, I can't expect them to look at me and be like, oh, did he make
but
that?
But you can't make the
did
shot.
Did he make that?
Wait, go to the block and act like, no, nigga, you should have said something. We that 3-point line.
Yeah, you got to call out somebody on their bullshit immediately.
Immediately.
The purpose of this whole podcast.
And because... And Bam know, everyone know in the league that he's sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
And Bam like, man, look, man, I'm taking your ball. Nigga, do something about it.
Yeah.
I'm taking your ball. Do something about it.
Please, said, do something about it, what he said when KD reached for the ball was, man, you are not about to take this ball from me.
You're not about to take it from me.
Ooh. Now it's on social media. Maybe that's why he posted, because he seen Bam.
Honestly, if you're really just trying to hold up your reputation, you should have just swung at him anyway. Well, I would have respected that. I would have respected the hell out
right.
of that.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
You would have swung at him. I don't care if Bam whipped your ass. I'd have been like, hey, he
got down.
He felt some kind of way about it.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, yeah. But
I would have thought he was real convicted about that.
Yeah. And also, from Bam's perspective, nigga. If you're not doing the whole, where we still in this groove,
now you're
stepping up to me.
It
must have
not been a big deal.
Like trying to bully me for the ball, trying to bully me for the ball, and where I can understand, you're not going to just come take the ball from me.
The whole.
If I could do it, nigga.
If we're gonna break down the etiquette, and how far are we in here? We about 10 minutes in. Okay, this is good. If we're going to break down the etiquette for change, this is the etiquette, okay? You shoot the shot. It's two guys on the court, right? It's two dudes on the court.
Yeah.
Two random dudes walk on the court. Both of them know the etiquette for change, right?
At the parks.
So you shooting around. You shoot your shot. Dude shoots the ball back. You shoot your shot again. Dude start dribbling. Hey, change.
Hey, yeah.
That is the etiquette. That's the etiquette.
Bro,
number
you
one.
You have to use words.
If you forget, if you forget step number one, step number two is the quick reminder. The quick reminder. If you forgot step number two, you don't belong on the fucking court today.
Hey.
You don't belong on the court. Yeah,
yeah.
You so, don't work. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. That. The ball just went. Did you not see the ball go in the basket? Here. Yeah. Right here. Give that's that it. Right. Now, if dude got a problem with you, or if he's being specifically unreasonable, he's going to say something right then and there. If he's not, you're going to get the ball back.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right?
He's going to respect you.
Bam would have given the ball back. He would have just made, made that. Boom, boom, give me that. Bam looks like an asshole on camera.
Well, and let's also be fair. There were multiple balls being shot at the same
time. Yeah, a lot of basketballs. Yeah, this is the NBA. Or this is actually the Olympics. No lack of balls. Giggity. Pause. No lack of balls on that court. No lack of balls on that court. You could have picked up any of them.
Hey, we should giggity instead of pause.
Giggity.
I like the giggity.
I like that. You just saw something.
Yeah, giggity. We've been saying giggity for years.
Yeah, but we need to make it a sound.
Okay. Yeah. For real.
Even if I play pickup ball at parks, you make a shot, niggas are automatically know to get that ball back. Yeah. And like Brian said, if they don't know with that etiquette, hey, that's me, bro. Oh, okay, bet. It's so simple that it shouldn't have gone to this.
Yeah, we shouldn't have to be talking about this. You shouldn't have. It's an unspoken rule. Yeah. Change is an unspoken rule. You get it explained to you one time. You want to play change? Do you want to play change? Okay, what's change? You make the ball, you get it back. That's the rules.
That's it. Nothing.
And change starts the minute you walk on the court. Change starts. Hey, you're always playing change. Hey, you're always playing change.
You want to know how I learned about change? Playing on the court, street ball, and somebody make it. As soon as I get it, they say, "Hey, give my change."
Yep, give my change.
Yeah. I was like, "Pockets, what? Yeah. No. Give my change, nigga. I made it. Oh, the ball.
Yes.
Boom. And I never had to be taught again.
Yeah, you get a return. You get a return on that investment.
Yeah,
he made that one.
And niggas at the parks. I mean, I see niggas pull out guns on the park.
Oh, yeah.
Also, hey, foul, huh? What? I said foul.
At the park,
pull some guns out.
Yeah, it gets real.
So, nigga, if you ain't getting nigga change at a park, if you playing in the hood or somewhere,
come on.
You're going to learn really quickly that when a nigga make a shot, you're going to give it back to him.
Yeah.
You're going to learn real quick.
You better give me this
you gonna
ball.
You're going to play at Jefferson? Go play at Jefferson. Go play at fucking Super Creek. Go play at Gritsville Park. You don't know real quick that nigga, when the nigga make a shot, go better give the chain back.
That whole part, cuz.
This dude's writing down where not to go right now.
I ain't playing. Grizzly, I ain't playing. No. But you gonna know.
Yeah, you gonna find out.
It's just basketball etiquette. Sure. If you've been playing for a minute or whatever.
And not for nothing, bro. This would not be a story if it was anybody else besides KD.
Yeah, this is the problem.
Because we know that this is how
As me and Maury said on two separate situations, that it just make you look like a bitch ass nigga. It really does. And then Maury came and then he was like, Maury came in and said he's just being a bitch. And I was like, thank you. That's just what you look like. It's what you look like. The fact that you look like you sweating it make you look like a bitch.
You sweating it. But it's your fault that you sweating it because you didn't say.
Yes.
And you went to the block.
Yeah.
Give me my ball now at the 3-point line. I just made it right here, nigga. Give me the ball back.
Yeah.
But bro, my niggas are that simple,
man. Yeah.
My niggas our age.
Well, get your shit straight.
About 32, 33-ish?
Oh, well, KD?
I think he's just awkward.
Isn't he?
I know how old he is.
I think he's just awkward, dude, probably.
Y'all is not.
How old is KD? You know how old he is?
I thought he was 32.
Oh, shit. Here we go. I'm going to say it right now. KD is the same age as me. He's 33. I'm going to go for 33.
You a lie.
God damn it.
He ain't 33.
He's 33.
I don't even sound right. He ain't 33.
He at least 33. He's not in his 20s.
No, he's not in his 20s. Yeah, no. It's shit. No, okay. He's not in his 20s.
All right.
Let me see.
What's up? What's up? Hold on. Don't look. What's up, man?
What's the parameters?
What's the parameters? Is he 33 or not?
He called you a lie. What's the parameters?
The parameters is I think it's 33. No, and he doesn't, and you need to pick a side.
No. What's the penalties?
To be decided by Maury, right? You called it out. What's up?
I do push-ups.
There you go. 20 push-ups.
Ooh, man. Yeah, he ain't 33. I don't think he's 33.
I'm going to go with 33.
If he's 33, I'll be surprised. But yeah, I mean, come on now. Why are you so sensitive, man? How old is he?
This nigga's birthday is September 29th, 1988.
So how
is he 32? Did I miss it by a month?
You missed it by a month.
You motherfucker!
A month and a half.
Goddamn!
That's
some bullshit.
I can't be right and wrong at the same time.
He'll be 33 in a month.
He'll be 33, literally.
Bro, use my show, my brother. Go ahead and do them push-ups.
That's some bullshit. It's 20 man.
Recording.
That's
recording.
Some bullshit.
Anyway, all right, let's do this.
It's 20, right?
Come on.
20, a dub. Dub. No, no.
One.
Dos.
Two.
Tres. Cuatro. Cinco.
Six.
Okay, I can make out the 10, bro. I can do that.
Once. Doze. Trece, catorce,
Brian said, you ain't not seen nothing on my shit. I think Brian's adamant on not showing nothing.
Okay.
But yeah, wrapping this shit up.
Wrapping up, final thoughts. Final thoughts.
Final thoughts, man. KD, I mean, I'm not surprised that you're going to put some shit out.
Yeah, not Kevin Durant.
He's on Instagram or whatever it was. Man, he being disrespectful and dudes like, man, you just trying to little bro me, bro. Like,
well, it makes you look bad because then you think back on this, and this is going to be my final thought. You think back on that Michael Rapaport shit.
Same shit.
And you know, he's laughing about something completely unrelated.
Unrelated.
But yeah, you think about that Michael Rapaport shit, and you think, well, I mean, how credible is he now? And my thing is with KD's tweets, that he never directly denies what the person said. But he'll try to
like downplay it.
Downplay it. So I don't
know.
As a person, don't like him. As a basketball player, the best offensively to do it.
Yeah, he's a walking bucket.
Yeah.
He's a walking bucket for sure.
Well, my final thoughts on this is be on the lookout for Brian's OnlyFans coming to a city near you. Man,
49.99, you go in. We'll tax you too, man. Shipping and handling too.
And you know people would pay for it because I don't
he
want
gonna
to
start
see it.
$15.99.
KD, man.
I don't want him to see it.
KD, you are top three in the league, two, probably in the league.
What no. are these
Why
stats
so
based on?
Sensitive? What, KD, top in the league?
Is that just on his stats? Like, what
beast,
is that
bro,
based on?
That nigga
on?
Is a beast, bro.
You know what?
Yeah,
how about y'all let – what do you guys think? Let us know in the comments
below.
Why is KD so sensitive?
And where do you rank him?
Yes, and where do you rank him?
Top three easily.
Yeah. That's your top three. I want the audience to let us know.
And does
let me know who you got better than him.
Does his bitch acidness affect your opinion of his game? There you go. Let us know in the comments below.
I don't want to answer that because it's going to extend this conversation another 15 minutes.
And this conversation is over.
Just shout out to my brother. Chris, we still thinking about you, brother. Just want you to know.
Ah, bro. Yeah. We miss you.
Next subject, though. Man, y'all know me. I got to bring
the politics in the game.
The politics in the game, bro.
I'm glad that you do that because I be paying attention a lot more since you be doing that. For real.
It's important to pay
you bring it out. Like, all right, look into it.
Yeah. It's important. The reason why I decided it's important to pay attention to for myself personally is because without paying attention, you miss all the motherfuckers that are making decisions that affect your life on a personal level.
Yeah.
And you have no idea where shit is coming from, why this is happening, why is this tax going up, why is that going down, why now?
I don't want to follow this too deeply because then we'll get into a philosophical discussion of why people follow politics. But when you do follow,
not following it, but just being aware.
When you do follow, when you follow, however closely or loosely, when you do follow, you get this sense of powerlessness. Like, what can I'm involved? I can see my direct involvement in this situation, but I don't see how I can change it. That's the defeatedness. That's why a lot of people ignore things.
And that's why a lot of people avoid politics.
That's why a lot of people avoid and ignore it.
A lot of people feel like ain't shit you can do anyway because all these motherfuckers making decisions.
This is why we're going to bring up a very sensitive thing coming up.
This particular topic, for example, the state of Texas has just passed a law. I'm gonna get it right so that y'all can look it up for yourselves and shit and have the information because I don't want to just be up here.
I wish he would have just said the law. That would have made this episode a lot more interesting.
You got that.
For real.
Hey, call that.
We'll let him look it up.
The law is called.
He said he being safe. He know what he's doing.
It's called.
Just say it, man. Just say it. You know it. You know about it.
Well,
he know about it.
Yeah, but there's letters and numbers, and y'all niggas be talking about that.
You know by heart.
Let's see. It's a Senate Bill 3.
What was the law?
House Bill 3979.
What are they banning? As far as like...
I'm sorry. I'm going to read this right. The author of HB 3979, which is the House bill that I'm talking about that was actually signed into law, it was passed in Texas. Y'all don't have to trust me on that, but trust me, it's been passed into law. The author told House members that critical race theory, we'll get into that later, rejects the rule of law as a disguise for a selfish interest of supposedly white supremacist American society. So in other words, it's to reject the notion of white supremacy being a foundation of American history.
Like it never happened.
Altogether. Not that it never happened, but you can't teach it to our kids in school.
And you're not allowed to tell people how we used
really
to
happened.
Be. Yeah. Right. You're not allowed to tell people how we used to be.
So
this is false already.
Texas,
tell the fucking real shit, man.
Texas passed a bill that stops or doesn't, not stops, but doesn't require or rewrites their curriculum to not include anything race related, women's rights related, or anything that paints the foundation of America as racist or any of the foundations as racist or any of our systems, the KKK, any of that. As inherently racist.
I'm not surprised that Texas is the first state to do that.
Dude. I'm not
surprised
either.
That Texas is the state doing it either.
I'm not surprised at all, bro.
Not surprised at all.
I mean,
not surprised.
Texas is a whole fucking mess.
Yes.
They think that, you know, because there's some rivalry that goes on that really Californians don't understand with Texans. like you go to Texas and you say you're from California, and I assume you get this whole ass attitude. You go to California. You come to California, you say you're from Texas, and be like, oh.
Okay, cool. That's
fine.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't care.
But here's the thing. A lot of people are leaving California
and going to Texas.
To Texas, yeah. And this is what they're moving into. Mind you, and here's the problem that I have. They want to shield white kids from white guilt or American history and from the truth.
Yes.
While in the same time teaching white kids or teaching kids, period, that... You know, a complex issue such as sexuality can be explained in elementary terms. You can fucking understand transgender.
But you don't want to hold accountability. You don't want to hold accountability for racism in your country.
But when you get to racism in the country, now our kids can't handle that. They can't understand
because it's too real. Because it might affect those kids as soon as they walk out the door.
Or
that's how it is here.
Kids already have a bullshit monitor, so. Just elementary wise, by the time they get to kindergarten and they learn the 10 Indians and the
oh my god, yeah, some of the racist shit that we got taught back in the day, it would not fly today.
It would not. Ooh,
and
fly
we're
today.
And I'm only, I mean, I'm 33 years old. I'm not, you know, whatever. I'm 33. I guess I'm a man in his prime, but like I'm not that old.
We're
old enough that there's shit that they would not be saying. The shit that they taught us, they would not be saying to you in California,
at least,
in Texas. I don't know what they blowing smoke up them kids' asses. But here, like 10 years ago, like some of the shit they were saying, they would not be saying it here. You'd be losing your job.
Yes, exactly. And it's bothersome because. Like I said, you can teach these kids everything on sexuality and acceptance and all this stuff. But when it comes to teaching that same concept for black people or learning true history of black people in this country, all of a sudden y'all feel like this is too heavy for our children.
Yeah,
y'all
they can't have
them.
They're
guilt
too young.
Complexes and white guilt and all this stuff. And all.
Bro.
Let's just call it what it is.
That's
it. Y'all niggas afraid of the truth.
That's it.
Nobody wants to confront America's true history, which is why it's been so strategically whitewashed from us. Like, there are so many.
And I feel like
the reason we got to this point is because a lot of people learned outside of high school, outside of college, actual history that goes to, that is backed by documented instances and policies and laws that are
it's a double-edged sword
all, and you find out on your own.
Yeah,
you got to do the research.
It's a double-edged sword.
On your own, bro.
How much information is available to us? Because that is a good thing that you can do that. But some people will do the research and find out the wrong shit.
Yeah, or internalize it as now I'm angry because I've just learned all this shit, and I've been deceived my whole life to think. I've had thoughts growing up that made me kind of anti-black because I bought into the whole idea of I don't want to be like those black people because they're a stereotype, or I don't want to fit the stereotype because that's what we was taught. I don't want to be like this because this. And then you learn the history, the actual history of things that has been going on in this country. And you learn, like, whoa, wait a minute. Everything y'all been trying to tell us
teach us and shit. It's not just a lie.
It's complete bullshit.
It's to follow a certain model.
They know what the fuck they're doing.
The white model.
But that's the thing. We, as Americans, are quick to say, this is for the children. Protect the children. Protect the children. Oh, Hillary Clinton and them have a child sex trafficking ring. Lock them up and arrest them because protect the children.
Speaking of that shit.
This education shit has a lot to do with the fucking children. But let's make something clear. This is coming from this idea of critical race theory and shit. I didn't even know that that's not even taught in school, except for college as an elective or a law school when they teach you critical race theory. Which is the teaching of how race...
That's an actual class you can take.
Which teaches how race plays a part in our systems and our
foundation. It plays a huge part in everything, bro.
It's not even taught in schools. But they're passing this law now saying that even the basic shit that we've been taught in school can't be taught, don't have to be taught and shit. And I want to read off a list of specifics from this bill that you know are amended. They call it amended.
Bro, I'm a realist. Give me what is the truth. Give me what's up. So I'm not with this fucking beating around the bush. Man, give me the truth on what really happened. And like you said, if you want things done yourself, the right way, do it yourself. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the research myself and see what's really going on or what happened in the past.
And that's why we keep finding out shit.
Well, Murray,
what's about?
There's a problem. The truth does not benefit the people in power.
It doesn't.
Yeah, it don't.
It actually hurts them.
Yeah.
I mean, you ain't gonna make as much money. You're not gonna be able to influence policy. Mm-hmm. What do? You lie.
That's what you do. Hey, what did it say? Fake it till you make it.
Fake it till you make it. Fake it while you make it. Fake it after you make it. And keep on faking it.
So here's the
thing. You be a faker your whole life.
Here's the things that they're attempting to fucking...
Fake fucker. Fake fucker. Niggas out there. Man, you out with you? Come on.
Yeah, you fake you boy. No, fake you fuck boy.
I just want to read off a list of things they were attempting to block from being taught
in schools or whatever.
The founding documents of the United States, including the Federalist Papers and the transcript of the first Lincoln-Douglas debate, writings from Frederick Douglass's newspaper, The North Star, the Book of Negroes, the Fugitive Slave Acts of 1793 and 1850, the Indian Removal Act, Thomas Jefferson's letter to the Danbury Baptist, Will Steele's Underground Railroad records, and these are just some.
So my question is, why are they doing this? What's the reason for them to all of a sudden, you know, we're not teaching this?
Well,
why is that?
Would you like to know? Like, the simplest word would be mind control.
Yeah.
If you control education, you control how people think. If you control people's knowledge,
at an early age,
yeah, and you control. Is it
in high school? The whole education.
This is from elementary on up.
So the thing is, why should you guys be comforted about this? Because the thing is, what's the best way to know to make sure that everybody knows about something? Is to ban it. When everybody finds out that something's banned, that's when it becomes hot.
That is true.
When you're hiding, when everybody knows that you're hiding something, that's when you go looking for it.
I never even wanted to read The Bluest Eye until it was banned from being taught in school.
Yeah, that lets you know that it's worth looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Other subjects include Martin Luther King Jr.'s letter from a Birmingham jail and the I Have a Dream speech. The U.S. Supreme Court's decision in Brown versus Board of Education, which established school segregation as unconstitutional.
That's crazy as fuck.
The Snyder Act of 1924, which granted citizenship.
These are things that you're not allowed to teach people?
This is things you're not allowed to teach people.
The Texas school system.
Incredible that there's a list that does that.
And it's not necessarily allowed. It's just that it's not going to be required as part of the curriculum anymore.
So they're not
going to
teach it.
So, the Snyder Act of 1924, which granted citizenship to indigenous people or Native Americans, the Emancipation Proclamation, which freed slaves.
Okay.
The Universal Declaration of Human Rights.
I don't think we need the whole list. I mean, I think you've made
the 26th Constitutional Amendment, which made the voting age 18 years old. All of these are planned to be are blocked or not blocked, but not included in the next in the curriculum in Texas.
What is the question I want to? I don't know how to frame this question.
Frame it. Frame it how? Don't be diplomatic. Just say it.
What? Who was in charge of making these decisions on these lists? Who's in charge of making these lists on this is what we don't need to teach these kids now?
I would think there's an entire committee, but the person that pulls the trigger on that.
There's got to be some strong nigga out there and be like, you know
what? The person who pulls the trigger on that is probably going to be the governor, right? Okay. All right, hold on. We're going to pause.
There is a whole wing of people who back that, and there's a specific.
But there had to be one person, but like, you know what?
There's
fuck
a specific
all
person who drafted that yes. bill. And that's
who
doing.
Made this shit up?
I'll let you
Who's
know
the nigga that made all this up? Like we need, like, bro. So we're gonna have the kids from kindergarten up. They don't know nothing about MLK speech. None of this.
Well, they've been doing that already. It's just they made it. They've just
made it
allowed it in legislation, which is whatever. The thing is that when you specifically get rid of information that stays on record and it doesn't disappear from everywhere. It just disappeared from wherever everybody is trying to discount that information. It's going to be big anywhere else. You might be able to suppress education. Like for the duration of a lot of kids' lives in Texas in that population, but a lot of them gonna get out. A lot of them gonna get out, and they're like it's not hard to figure out the world. It's not hard to see the shape of the world. It's gonna treat you. You're gonna find out really quickly where you stand, like real quick. But you know, there's probably value to that because if you can't get a good foothold in life, then you can't change things.
Yeah,
you can't change things.
Yeah.
So the author. Of this bill that was accepted. Senator Brian Hughes, a Republican of Mineola.
You did it!
Just call me
he
Trail.
Introduced
Damn it.
The version of this bill, 3979, that also requires the State Board of Education to develop new standards for civics education. It says the Senate approved the bill in an 18-13 vote over opposition from educators, school advocacy groups, and senators of color who worry it limits necessary conversation about the roles of race and racism played in
racism,
U.S. history.
Racism,
18-13.
Texas ain't that far from flipping. Y'all know that's why they getting this.
No,
heavy,
that's why they're doing it.
That's why there's heavy legislation.
And that's why there's heavy legislation on their voting laws.
Texas is almost a purple state, and what that means is that there's the Democratic influence is just as strong as the Republican influence. And the problem with Texas is that they are team red.
They prided themselves on being conservative for so long.
It's not just the word red is important, but also the word team. Like they are it's important to some people that they belong to something. Whatever. To California, it don't matter to us. We know that we're Democratic because that's just where we have to stand. But to people in Texas, we're bright red. We's of the right. We're never going to be blue. But like, bro, I don't care what fucking color I am. What's the policy on the bill they passing? Is it going to affect my paycheck or not?
I'm with Brian. I don't care what color it is. My thing is, does it reflect our actual population of this damn state?
Yeah.
So if most of Texas supports the purpleness of the state, then it makes sense. The same thing for California. California has always been a Democratic fucking state. They've always voted that way. But I expect that because that's us as California, that's what's reflected in our population. There's a lot more liberal people in California than conservative people. Texas has historically been more Republican, more conservative.
Nowadays,
don't know what those values even mean anymore.
And the problem is Texas is so pro-freedom that they're almost Democratic.
Thank you.
Right. It is. It's crazy. Yeah. So Democrats are moving to Texas because of the freedom that they have. Yeah,
freedom.
But their culture is going to change there a little bit. Texas.
Yeah.
Texans
they don't like California.
They don't.
Like
they don't
that,
like
bro.
Our. They don't like our attitude.
What the old girl saying Cancun?
Huh?
We met a female in Cancun. She said, "Man, why y'all California moving to Texas? Y'all fucking up everything."
Well, what about that?
Did she
dude?
Not say that?
What about that dude that worked in oil?
She said that.
Y'all don't remember that? The dude that worked in oil that we talked to that was from Texas? And he was like, oh, you motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Like, we really
Back as hell, huh?
Yeah.
California, like, huh?
California.
But she really
huh?
did say that.
She said that. Why y'all fucking up? Y'all fucking up?
We? Like, are we? Are we really?
That's what she said.
Well, what's happening is we're changing the voting block. Yeah. All the gerrymandering and shit that y'all try to do and shit, it's not going to work because now those
places are
being filled with people from California.
When you make changes, like the system is not going to run smoothly for the people that it was meant to run smoothly for. Mm-hmm. And it might gum up the works a little bit down the way. But when you fix stuff, eventually the stuff at the bottom is going to work. It's the people who at the top not going to get the same return. And that's the problem. There's a yield at the top that's not down there at the bottom and it's breaking shit. And when the yield stops showing up at the top, that's the real issue. Well, anyway, we can find
most people who probably wouldn't miss a meal if it did change.
We can final thought this, though. You know, your thoughts on education suppression. What's the point behind it?
Why?
You know,
yeah,
is
why,
there,
why?
Is it successful? Is it not? Is it ultimately not? The nature of humans, you know, when you hold back knowledge, like we don't really appreciate it. Like, what do y'all think?
I think that it's a problem because we're already so far behind because of the strategic teaching of our A through G or kindergarten high school curriculum that we all been taught up until this point.
Yeah. Mm.
And that has already been filled with a lot of lies and mistruths.
America is highly aware of narrative. That's why we are the number one output of entertainment.
Yes.
Mm. You think we can't spin some shit?
Hmm. Oh, that part.
Easy.
But it's to me it's important.
Easy.
Because without real history and real knowledge, we are doomed to repeat the same motherfucking shit. And we are doing that shit.
Well, it's interesting because you can mix up history with entertainment. That's the fucked up part. You can take a book. You can take two books and call them the same thing.
Yeah.
So a lot of people will say the Bible is different from a fantasy novel. A lot of people will say there's no fucking difference.
It's the same shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Boy,
you know what I'm
that?
Saying?
Don't you start that conversation.
All right. All right. Let us know in the comments. All right. It got a little too deep. But yeah, let us know.
Is Texas tripping?
Yes.
No, they tripping.
Probably.
Is Texas tripping?
Probably.
Should they not be outlawing these teachings that they should be teaching to kids now?
Put it in the comments down below. Audio listeners, let us know in Discord, you know, whatever. Hit us up.
iTunes.
We're gonna move on to the next one, which is really a doozy, which is crazy because we've been on this topic for like a half hour.
But if you can't get with it, homeschooling is still working.
Yeah. All right, Maury, bring us in, man. What's
our next topic is, man, we're talking about a relationship. I ain't gonna say a problem, but just a relationship period. Far as you and your significant other, are you doing enough for your significant other to stay around, to be with, to love? Is love enough? That's the question. Is love enough?
Is love
to stay with somebody for X amount of years? I mean, every situation is different. Sherman said no already. Sure, said no already. But is there situations like, you know what? But they said love don't pay the bills.
It's just, what do you call love?
What do you call
got
love?
To do,
got to do with it. That's the topic for this. That's the topic for this topic.
It might be the episode title.
Love enough.
What's love got to do with
it? What's love got to do with it? What is going to keep you around for the long haul, for the struggles, the endurance, everything in the relationship or marriage? We're gonna talk about that right now.
We're talking about that right now, and we'll drop. And you know, whoever brought the people who brought this up ate at the table. So we're gonna let them. You know, we'll drop the clip and we'll put in all the important parts so you guys can see, and we'll frame it around that right now.
So what's good, people? Tonight we're gonna be talking about, is love enough?
No.
So I'm gonna kick it off, and then since Rico said no, he's gonna go next. So my opinion, love isn't enough.
Is or isn't?
It's not. Love is not enough. And there's two types of love. There's romantical and then there's companionship. So like when this comes to romance, you know, it's the beginning of the puppy stage love. People think like that's all they need to propel them through. But when you live on this earth long enough, you realize you need more than that, right? It's more than just, you know, we had good sex, the date, the money. Like, then you start realizing, okay, what's next? So in my opinion, love isn't enough. And for the companionship that I also mentioned, that's another thing. Like, you start off like, this is my best friend, this is my lover, the closeness, but then you get codependent. Then you, it's almost like you're running yourself dry and you realize, what else is there to propel that relationship? What else is there to sustain it? And you see people either cheat, you know, lie, or dwindle and break apart. So I don't know. Love is not enough. You need more than that. I feel like to keep the love, what you need is intimacy.
Number two.
Communication.
There
and
you
passion,
go, right there.
And to tie it all in.
Right there.
Consistency. And you got to keep choosing each other.
Right
it's
fucking
like a
there.
Bridge. A bridge.
You got to keep choosing each other.
Right there. Well,
then there's a lack of communication because.
Right
you
fucking
know,
there.
That's the bad communication.
Wait, pause that.
All right, we'll pause it.
Wait, pause that because this we're nigga gonna, said.
It's going to be a long one.
You need.
It is.
No, he's right. No, it's important. He said you need intimacy.
We're going to keep playing it too.
Intimacy. Right.
You need communication.
That's what happened, bro. But communication, that's a fuck. That is the number one.
What was that third thing he said?
Look. In a relationship to me, bro, I mean, I'm a fuck you good, bitch. Whatever. But communication, that is number one to
we'll
me.
Find the third one again.
Number one, communication for me, bro. That's just me personally.
He didn't even say communication first. What was the first thing he said?
Intimacy.
Intimacy. That's important.
That's important, too. That's I'm going to go ahead and let it pipe
intimacy
down.
Intimacy
yes.
is not just sex,
not just,
though.
Yeah, I was about to say, not just sex. It's the dates, too. I mean, it's
the
time. Honestly,
it's the dates.
Listen,
it's the playful flirting at home.
If you can trust
it's
a woman, you like it when...
For someone over and over again.
If you can trust her, you also like it when a woman is inside your head, too. It's better
right?
when somebody knows what you like.
Yeah, exactly.
You
yes.
know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So if you can trust that person, then intimacy is great.
Mm-hmm.
But if you can't trust anybody, then intimacy is an issue.
Yes.
But yeah, that's my take on that specific mm-hmm. part. But he said a third thing there. We'll see. I ran it back 30 seconds.
What else is there to sustain?
We might
and
blah, blah,
you
blah,
see
blah,
people either cheat, you know, lie, or dwindle and break apart. So I don't know. Love is not enough. You need more than that. I feel like to keep
feels,
the love, what you need is intimacy, communication, and passion. Mm-hmm. And to tie it all in, consistency. And you got to keep choosing each other.
Yeah,
it's like a bridge. A bridge.
Yeah. Oh, people think you mistake consistency for
complacency.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Consistent
versus complacent.
You know what? I'm just used to this.
Let's see.
Yeah, put it in the mic because I can hear.
Let's let Sherman hold
here.
It. Oh, yes.
Then there's a lack of communication because, you know, that's the bad communication, bad breath. Mm-hmm. Your mouth is stink.
Your mouth stink.
No, I'm putting it right here.
Dirty bitch.
How could you communicate? But through text. But just to wrap up what I'm saying, it's like when it comes to love, I look at it like it's a choice and like building a bridge. Like a bridge has been up for years because you keep working at it, you keep working mm-hmm. at it, you keep working at it. It doesn't
takes
stop.
Maintenance.
So mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
Bridges don't just stay up.
Nah,
you know, like,
at all.
Crazy. You know
yeah, you're right, Brian.
People say, looks for get you through the door.
Yeah, right.
It's
yeah.
not going to keep you there.
Mm-hmm.
And when you, eventually you're going to have something to bring to the table.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's how love works.
Why is it always foreign bitches that recognize or understand this?
Because they know true brokenness. She done had to work. She where she at? She is under no illusions. That woman, I couldn't deal with her because she's too real. She way too fucking
real.
She's
from
a
place that they really don't give
mm-hmm.
women
real.
That freedom to be empowered and shit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She had to make her way up.
Yeah.
Or go through some shit to get to where she at.
Yeah, she been through some shit.
Yeah, she been through some shit. You can tell she been through some shit.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So
if you
far,
lock
we all know that.
Deals,
we ain't got her pegged.
It's not
going to
work. You know what I'm saying? You fall in love. It's fine. You know what I'm saying? You could get you there. It's
too.
Fun at the
good
first,
God.
Whatever. But like, when I feel like when rents start coming in, bad sex is coming in, it's going to hit you like, damn, like,
we won't even address
what
it.
Can I do to keep that person that you want to be with, because love is not enough. Love is never enough. I don't care what people say. Like, it could only go so far. That's why people do not understand. You get what I'm saying? It's just like people be like, oh my God, you know, like, sex is not everything. You know,
Because she said love is not enough, right? That's what she's saying in her maybe her experience or whatever. But I talked to females in the past that get their ass whooped by these niggas that they with, and I said, you know what? Why do you stay with this dude? Because I love him.
I'm throwing my hands up
in. So in essence, so love is in your
situation. Love is enough because
when it comes to abuse,
you love because he beating your ass, doing this and that. You're not gonna break with him because you love him. But you come across a real nigga that's gonna treat you right. You don't know how to respond to it. But because used to this ass beating and you getting put in the hospital and this and that and getting treated dirty, you love him because I'm not gonna break. I love him. I'm not gonna go nowhere.
Well, it seemed like an old person cliche when an old person said, like, you don't even know what love is and
at all.
You the simple truth is that unless you really experience it in the deepest levels, you really don't.
And that we need to send the collection plate around for this preacher here.
Offering plate.
This man of God here who's preaching on this subject here tonight. Yes. Because how is it that love is enough for you to stay in an abusive relationship?
Right?
I love him. I love him. Yes.
That has potential to be built on.
Yeah.
Love is not enough.
Because what you're calling love is just some other emotion.
But they come across a dude that's respectful, sweet, caring about your well-being, this and that. But they don't know how to respond to it because they never been loved like that. They have never been introduced to nothing like that ever. But they're used to getting beat on, spit on, this and that.
You want
to
be real? Y'all want to be real?
Let's go.
Why haven't you left that nigga yet? He makes me wet. There you go. That's it.
That could be it too.
No, when I see abusive relationships, I always say that. I always say,
yes,
that nigga must have good penis. Giggity.
Giggity.
Because there is, you can't think of
I can
what see else.
No passing. That's
you can't
I like.
Just say love because it's no. obvious love is
like,
not
you
enough
like, you like,
in a
you
healthy
like that
relationship.
Really got going on with you.
Yeah. So, yeah, it has to be something else. Yeah. The way yo cootie cat feel after you get done with a nigga is
confused.
That helps.
What you doing?
It's an added.
That's what fucks his mind up, bro. That's what keep him around. You get their ass whooped, black eyes, this and that. They get to the hospital.
Nigga, I watched this show with my mom the other day called Love After Lockup. You know what this shit is about?
Niggas getting out of prison.
Motherfuckers who find love after falling in love with motherfuckers who's been locked up. Mm-hmm. Whether you male, female, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
Motherfuckers who, and I'm talking about women, beautiful women that got businesses, money, goals, success. They seek men in prison to get with, to be with, and all this stuff, and they fall in love with these niggas, and they get out of prison.
You know what?
And when they get out of prison, thank you for being everything I needed while I was in there, but now that I'm out, I'm trying to do my thing. And instead of being like, oh, this is nigga, and wash their hands, I love him. We even love him. And they risk.
What's your name, Brian? If you think, but then again, if you think love is a dude hitting on you, being on you, abusive to you, whatever, that's what you think love is. Okay, whatever. I can't. And if you come across a nigga like us, that respectful, caring, man, you a bitch. You a pussy nigga. Hold on. I'm respectful.
Or I'm bored. Or I need excitement.
I need you to hear me for me to like feel like this. I show my shit different, bro. I'm not here beating on your ass. I'm not doing none of that shit, bro. I'm not doing that.
I want to shine together, grow together, grind together. That's
but
what
about females,
to me.
I ran across two last. Yesterday,
they thrive on drama.
They thrive on that shit, bro. I'm in my head, bro. I was lost for words. I had nothing. I said, "Wow." I said, "You know what? You strong as fuck." Because I said, "If a bitch talks to me wrong,
is that strength?"
Honestly, bro, if you say it with a nigga like that, in a sense, it is, but it's not.
I think it take more strength to leave, guys.
Yeah, hell yeah, yeah.
I think it take more strength to leave.
Yeah, because you see, nigga already that's beating your ass, right?
Yeah.
So when you leave, you over here. You making a man say, I'm not dealing with this shit no more. But if you when you say it with him, I'm used to it. I'm used to it. He love me. Whatever.
I feel like Brenda from a Scary Movie, and she's talking about her friend.
I look over, and there was your girl getting bucked wild in the jacuzzi.
So?
With a backup dancer. I mean, that's nasty. That's lower than a security guard. At least security can get you backstage. She don't love herself.
She's caught in the pool with a backup. She said a backup dancer? She don't love herself. And that's what it comes
down. Hey, that's real shit, though.
It comes down to the love you have for yourself.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yes. You are so 100% right, bro. If you don't see yourself as a, I can't say top notch, but you don't respect yourself to a certain degree, you don't keep allowing the shit. Because the one I was with last night, bro, nah, you seen her. Nice, bad.
I didn't.
Yeah, you didn't.
I was there. I said, God.
I'm not upset at all about that.
I said, you don't deserve none of this shit. Like, you look.
She was probably terrible looking.
Nah, she wasn't.
She was nice, bro.
God damn it. Shut up, Maury. I'm trying to.
Cute as fuck.
Bro, I said, this is before I knew her. Like, this is before I went out with her yesterday. Getting her ass. I'm like, you don't deserve none. Why would you put up with some shit like that? But then again, she... I love him. This is what I love. This is what I know.
Love.
Yeah.
It's enough now.
Yeah.
It's enough now.
So at what point do females be like, you know what?
You only deserve it if you're accepting it. You only deserve it if you're really accepting it. If you're completely aware of it and you're accepting it.
That is the only reason you deserve it
because you're the one that's serving it up to yourself. Mm-hmm. That's the only reason you deserve it. Is that it's not because of some reason of you and your flaws. Mm-hmm. The only reason that you deserve what you're getting is because you're accepting it. Yeah. That is it. This is a direct consequence of your actions.
Right.
But
everybody doesn't get to be in a position where they even can recognize that, right?
But a lot of people are in a position where they can recognize that, or at the very least, a lot of people are in a position where they could just, if they weren't too afraid, they could just say, "I'm done with the situation." I mean, it's life or death.
That's strong women.
It's life.
Strong
or,
women.
The problem is, it's life or death anyway. It ends up being that way anyway. I'm not trying to be a misunderstanding. Honestly,
no. Yeah, I love this dialogue.
I'm not discounting. I'm not discounding the things that you're about to bring up. Though,
I'm glad you're offering this. It makes a full conversation. Yes, it does.
There is a certain amount of there. We talk about this all the time. Men talk about this all the time. There's accountability. Even when things go wrong, we're held accountable. We get fined. We get put in jail. When something goes wrong, if you are at fault, you get held accountable in so many ways. But women don't get held accountable.
They don't
get held accountable for nothing. They don't.
Well, I'll tell you this now. After the video I just saw, the white girl that slapped dude in the face and he smacked her ass back and knocked her on her. Well deserved. She deserved that. You want to talk about equality?
Have we gone far afield here?
No, not at all. Not at all.
We're still kind of there, but we do need to address.
Yeah. But what I'm tying it to is the if you're gonna be in this position and allow. You get what you fucking allow to happen to your ass, but whatever you dish too. She in that specific example, old girl didn't know dude. She smacked him. He smacked her back. You got what you had coming.
Yeah, but
when I was in high school, I'm a freshman, 14 years old, nigga. Mm-hmm. A girl that I was in junior high with was dating one of my cousins, and I was on my way to class late one day and saw this nigga putting hands on her in the hallway at fucking BHS in Warren Hall. Had seen this nigga smacking her and grabbing her by her neck. Bitch, you. And I ran over like, yo, cuz, the fuck you doing?
Right.
You can't put your hands on this girl like that. What the fuck? And I knew her. She was my friend. So I'm really, it's a double thing. Like, I'm protecting her too.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, you not finna, that's fuck, that's stupid. That's
to both of them. This is a real bad,
it's a bad look.
Yeah.
It's a bad look.
Yeah, for sure.
Because, and the reason I brought this up is because even after all of that and she was crying and shit and I walked to the class.
But then
the next day.
Go ahead, say it, bro.
That's the problem with human nature.
The next day, these motherfuckers is holding hands outside in the quad.
And that's my motherfucking issue.
Holding hands in the quad outside in the middle of the fucking.
Why do females like niggas beating their ass?
Listen, man, that's toxicity. It's not. Don't generalize. Toxicity. The women like toxic men want that.
I ain't saying all females like women.
But you're right. There is a female tendency. There is a female tendency. Yes. Not the only female tendency. Everybody, the camera 1, 2, and 3. Just so y'all all know. Just so y'all all know.
Like and subscribe.
Like, come on. Come on, women. Let's be real. Y'all got a tendency to stick with the bad.
The bad boy. Yeah. I want the bad boy. They can protect me and shit. Well, but beat your ass left to right, though.
Wait,
you take your drug. You take your drug. You pick your drug and you roll with it.
But we almost say that as a cliche, but I really would like to pose the question to our listeners. Why is it, or what is it about y'all, especially females, because it's not just females, but especially females, what makes y'all feel like I have to have a bad boy? I like the, what is the appeal?
Because they like the.
And listen,
not from you.
Listen,
okay.
I don't want to hear.
I want to know
listen,
from y'all. Okay.
I understand that, but I want to omit the cliche answers. I don't want to hear the women that said, I thought I could change him.
Or the one that says, that's what it is, though. Being in another relationship is boring.
That is. That's,
I don't want to hear
that's,
that.
That's, one, that's fine, but there's something else here, and I want to tap into that. You thought you could change him? Okay, that's fine.
Let me know what
you're thinking. No. Tell me what was really going on. You say you thought you could change him. What was the plan? Please, women, tell me. What was your plan to change this man psychologically from bottom to top?
Well, you know what?
Girls say that shit and think it's cute.
I thought I could change him. I thought I could change him.
I thought females, for what? Like, man, I said, you know what? I need to find someone like you because you deal with all kind of bullshit and you seem to get a nigga all the time of the day. I can't find no one.
The problem is
I can't find no one to do shit like that. I'm already single and shit.
The problem is the problem is they think they need bullshit, so you don't want them. They think they need the bullshit.
Right, yes.
And that's the problem. Yeah. Like, you fill up on the bullshit. Yeah, you fill up. Yeah, she fills up on the bullshit.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
I like this. You know, because going off of that, you feed up and you internalize that as a successful or passionate relationship.
Yes.
And
that
is where you are delusional.
Fucking
and I don't use delusional a lot.
But I'm using right now.
I respect everybody's realities as they are. But that's a delusion to look at that and accept that and say, this is the example of a passionate relationship.
Which is crazy.
This is what I need.
This is going to make my life better.
This is excitement. No.
Weird
that's
shit.
That's drama.
Weird
that's
shit.
That's not excitement. Excitement is going fucking skydiving with your significant other to get an adrenaline rush.
Yeah.
Fighting over a liked picture on Instagram, that's drama. That's
drama.
Not excitement.
No, it's not. No, that's
it's not.
Bullshit. Yeah.
I had to break up a fight between my cousin who's this tall and his girlfriend who's this big. Yeah. They're fighting, fist fighting, and he's on her back with his arms around her neck. And I gotta fucking separate them just for them to go and fuck upstairs later and be happy about their relationship because the excitement and this shit keeps me, you know, engaged in the relationship. That is drama. That's not excitement.
No.
Y'all gotta stop confusing that. And that is abuse. That's not love.
No.
That's not love. I used to hate that shit. My dad used to whoop us and say, I'm doing this. Because
I love you.
And I used to be like, you don't love us, nigga. You hate us. Yeah. I don't want to make nobody I love cry. Hmm. But people internalize that as love. That's not love.
Right. Yeah.
That's toxic.
Yeah.
Yes. It's toxic.
It's not masculinity. It's not femininity. It's toxic behavior.
But when they see a guy.
It's toxicity.
Respectful, nice, sweet. The saying is, nice guys finish last.
They just write them off immediately.
Nice guys finish last.
You know, you say
supposedly nice guy fans. I said, what you mean? I said, niggas are sweet, caring, that I like you for you, whatever.
Respect you.
Yeah, respect you. You're not gonna choose him because you like the bad boy. You want the motherfucker to beat the fuck out of you.
Let's be real. No. Okay, let's be real about the realistic of a heterosexual norms. Men gotta be a little bit of a dick. You have to be a little bit of a dick,
bro, to fulfill sexual heterosexual norms. Yes,
yes,
you yes.
Which is why I hate the construct of that shit.
So when a guy is completely, it's hard to deal with for some women psychologically when a guy is completely considerate or whatever. And I'm just throwing shit in there. We just conjecturing. It is, you know, you can say, okay, well, there are some dudes that do too much.
Yeah.
There are some dudes that are way too accommodating.
Way too much.
And some women need to be told, like, bitch, I'm not doing that.
Bro, you know,
like it's that simple, right? And you need a woman that does the same thing. To be real,
yes.
To be real, like you'd be like, hey, I need a sandwich, right? It's 1 a.m. I'm hungry. I just woke up. I need a sandwich. You need a woman to be like, man, fuck you. You can get up and make your sandwich yourself.
You got two hands, right?
Yeah.
Make your sandwich yourself.
Yeah.
I'm sleep.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't know if this is really a pushback, but what I'm going to offer to that is that mindset usually comes with first world women.
Yeah.
You mean, what you mean about usually, first world women?
Well, not first world women. I think, well, when I say first world because we're heavily traditional, even in Western society, but we'll continue. Sure.
What I mean when I say first world is we're not dealing with third world problems. In a lot of third world countries, women don't even have a right to speak, drive, show themselves, none of that shit.
You better
so
shut the fuck
these
up.
Problems, yeah. These there's problems a lot of women right now still is in that already right offered there. As yeah. a privilege oh, yeah. in other situations. Yeah. When you get to that point of it, now you get to feminism and equality and women want to be equal and shit. Mm-hmm. But it's cool, and I'm for all of that, but here's my thing that I'm not for. I'm not for women equality when it comes to women doing whatever the fuck they want, but then not equality when it comes to men holding down traditional man roles or masculine roles in y'all relationship.
I'll add on to that. And also when it comes to not equality to the consequences of fallout from the relationships, women don't experience that. When you have fallout, whose side is the law going to be on?
Women.
The woman.
Easy. All
and
tops.
And let me tell you something. If you're not in America, all the women in America know that.
Yes. Easy.
That. And all the men in America know the women know that.
Easy.
So if you guys ever wonder about the dynamic of relationships in America, know that we all go into all of our relationships with that knowledge.
Yes.
Even
we know what's up.
Even with the impulse to fuck. Even with the urge to fuck. Even with the urge, even lacking protection, even making babies. We all understand and are aware of the laws that protect women in America and how biased the law is.
Now, back to the original question. Is love enough?
Is love enough?
I think we just explained that.
It is enough.
Conceptually, yes. Reality-wise, for y'all, no, it's not.
Because you need to understand that you don't know everything and you don't even understand that you don't know love right now. If you really love somebody, then you need to understand love as a deeper concept. That when the struggles come up, you ask the question, do I love this person?
If you
continue, right?
If you got to talk to someone that's mature enough to understand that shit, for one.
Yes.
Is you mature enough to understand that love is, look bitch.
Mm-hmm.
But look,
just say it.
This is what I want to do. I'm trying to do this shit with you for sure because I have done plenty of shit and whatever. I got whatever. I've done some shit.
Yeah, my arsenal is there, but you know what?
I got.
Yeah, I'll set it to the side for you.
Yes,
for sure.
For you, I will. It's stop not that, all this shit right now.
It's not that special, right? Like I like what I'm doing, but I like you too.
Yes, I like you enough to be something shit.
Choice to give my heart
I will
to
stop all
you.
Shit I'm doing for you.
And I gotta keep it that
That's
way.
Me. That's me for one giving all my shit right now. That's me giving up everything I got supposedly going for myself, whatever.
And really, that's big, too.
Bro, for a nigga, that's huge. That's
big.
Because I could be over here doing this, that, and the third. But I'm chilling with you.
He's talking about women, y'all, just so you know.
I'm chilling with you.
Exactly.
You, I'm not gonna say her name on camera, but the Cancun female, bro. I told her, I said, you know, if he was in Cali, I would take you serious. I would stop all the shit I'm doing right now for you.
But,
stop it.
But
you're not here.
Yeah. Damn, man. Ooh, that's rough. Ooh.
But you're not here.
Man, you could be the one, but you ain't here.
But you're not here.
Damn.
But you are.
Yeah, we didn't even.
You everything I need.
We didn't even get into long distance. That's okay. God damn.
You everything I fucking need, bro.
That's crazy.
Maury made a good point, and I'm going to add on to it about you not knowing what love is. A lot of us in America don't know what love
is. Don't know what it is.
Because we've been so programmed to have these misconstrued, fucked up visions.
Love is
a
continuous
action. Even from Disney, that was what I was going to say. Love is a continuous action. Action.
Never stops. You got
to
keep on
choose
giving it.
Every day to love
that's how
this
you find
person.
Out, that's how you find out if you love somebody because even when they
bullshit
on the worst and you just can't help it. And you just can't help it. And you got to that's the thing. There's fuel there. That's what people understand. They perceive it as a weakness. There's fuel there. That means that you got a never ending supply of this. You can make it. You can use it to make your life work.
Right.
People don't understand it about love.
I still love and have love for motherfuckers who have shown me everything but because and that's they how don't value. I know my they love for them was real.
Yeah. Right.
It's a, it's
because
a strength,
it's not
right?
based on yeah. how you treat me, how yeah. you do me. My love for you is not based on what I can get from you or if we're on a good space or in a good space or not in a good space. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Listen, my love is not based on that.
Let's answer the question.
So it's real.
Let's answer the question then.
But it's not enough.
So I'll say this. For me, if you're a person who can genuinely love, and this means that you don't put limits on your love.
Unconditional.
Then unconditional love. It is unconditional. People don't understand that yeah. that thing. So I'm just saying, if you're a person who can actually love, then it is enough because you understand the concept of love. You understand
yeah,
that
you love know what's, yeah, yeah,
so,
exactly.
So I'm going to go on my definition and say that in an absolute sense, love is absolutely enough. Love is absolutely enough. If you understand, if you're coming from love, if you're coming from
and
that
if you understand
position,
what love means,
if you're coming from love, that's the thing right when there. When two people are frustrated with each other, if you're coming from love, it's just like at the very least we can work on this later. Like at the very least we don't agree on this now and we can come back to it later, and mm-hmm. it's implied because mm-hmm. you love each other.
But
it
it's
don't matter
worth
if you,
exploring
yeah.
that deeper.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing with love is that with love, there's. Fuck man, I don't want to get this deep, but go ahead.
You said love, you know, talking about like a situation going on that you're gonna tap into it later. Mm. I'm the type of dude, I wanna know right now yes. what's going on with you. Now, you a married man, you been there, done that.
Yes.
When you face a problem or whatever it is, do you wait until, you know, I'm gonna see what's up later? Or do you be like, I need to know right now, what's going on with you right now so we can fix it?
Listen, man, and just like everything, you gotta deal with them. If you get married, mm-hmm. if you're in a relationship, a life, if you choose a life partner or whatever, you've decided for the rest of your life, right? So you gotta approach everything from that perspective. So. Well, wait, what was the question again? Because I had to frame what I was saying.
I'm sorry, y'all.
I just to understand.
How do you say if you see a problem, whatever, you're gonna face it later on
or right now?
Yeah, or right now. I'm gonna face it right now. You're not going to work. I'm gonna go ahead and call your boss. You ain't coming
my
to work.
Phrase, I'm like that too. But the problem is that it really is pick your battles. Like there's a point where there is no point in talking about it.
Yeah.
There's just no point. There's no point in me and you going any further with this. I don't even know why I'm talking. I can't help myself.
But
I need to shut up and move on.
Right?
Yeah.
It's not that something has been exhausted. It's just that there's no progress to be made tonight or then whatever. Yeah. Whenever the moment is,
we'll pick it tomorrow. The conversation.
We have
we'll
to
pick
it
up.
Because
I see you.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So things can't be forced.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Okay,
yeah,
I get
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I get that. Yeah,
things can't be forced. So, I think I was going to say, like, with love, and I'm not very biblical, but there are fruits of love. When they say the fruits of love, it's all the stuff that comes with what makes it work. With
patience, long-suffering, understanding.
Understanding, bro.
If everybody went over that checklist and understood what they was getting into when they say the word love, they wouldn't use it. They wouldn't say that. They wouldn't go over that. They wouldn't say, will I be patient? Will I be kind? Will I be like they would go over this and say, oh,
love somebody.
They would say, I only cover one of those things.
Perspectivize, I guess, if you love that person. I'm not willing to do all of that. So maybe it's not love.
It's not love.
It's not love because love is not
an emotion.
I like the vibe.
Yeah.
Love is not an emotion. Love is an action.
It is
in family. It can be an emotion because it's so deeply ingrained in you, but it's still an action. Right. It's still an action. You can't explain why you have to you know, be there for your sister. You can't explain why when, you know, shit falls apart, you got to break the bank to help your family. You can't explain that, but it's love.
A lot of problems we have today is because that element is missing out of a lot of families. You remember big
you
mamas and grandmas and aunties used to pull the family together every week for dinner and shit just to share love. They cook out of love.
Yes.
They socialize out of love and stuff.
Because of family, bro.
You need that stuff.
And nowadays it's missing.
I'm sorry. It's just missing a lot now. We've gone on so long, but my thing is I just wanted to make my argument for it. Is love enough? Absolutely. Absolutely. For me, absolutely. If I did not have love in my life, my life would be shit.
Right. Conceptually, it is. It is. Conceptually, it is.
My life will be garbage.
But when we're posing the question, relationship-wise, to the opposite sex, is love enough?
Do you need another person to complete you? Probably not.
Practically, it's not enough when you think about everything that comes with a relationship.
You don't need another person to complete you.
But when it comes to a relationship,
it'd be nice, though. It'd be nice.
Love is not enough in a relationship because relationships take more than love.
Too, bro.
Okay.
Relationships take more than love.
So a female getting her ass whooped, beat, hospital, whatever, and she said, I'm with him because I love him. It's love. At that point, is love enough right there?
You want my honest answer?
It ain't enough to keep a nigga from beating your ass.
I would immediately know that I'm not qualified to deal with this woman in any capacity. I'm not. I shouldn't be fucking you. I shouldn't be talking to you. Right. I shouldn't be therapizing
because you. Because you in a different league than me. You in a whole different league. I'm not all that shit. I don't know where you from, but damn it.
We've been there, but if she tells me a sob story about how her boyfriend whipped her ass, I'm be like, oh, I'm out.
That's it. Okay, I'm not as fast to be out as Brian, depending on the rest of that story. How long did you stay with the nigga after you start beating your ass?
That's the question.
Because if the nigga put hands on you and you decided to leave.
I don't know. How long have I known you?
Wait.
A few days?
Wait, but if you decide to leave and get away from that situation because you know you don't deserve that and I'm not going to put up with this and this abuse, we can actually still have something to talk about. But if you tell me, I've been with this nigga for 9 years, and he been beating my ass for 9 years, Sherman, and you still been there? Yeah. To be honest,
9 years.
That's not just a red flag, my nigga. That's a red tint. I cannot expect. This is
what I can do to be like
to get what I need out of you as a partner.
What you saying? If I was with him for like 2 months, and he beat me, and
okay.
No, I want to know how long he was with the nigga after he beat you.
Yeah, it's afterwards
because I can give you everything else. You ignored red flag. You ignored the signs.
And that's him being naive,
because
bro.
Because being in love, naive. He was naive.
I love him.
Yeah. But once the abuse started, how long did it take to get out of that?
Yes.
Because if you can be with a nigga that beat your ass for 10 years, you won't last with me for 10 minutes. Because I'm not going to give you what you're accustomed to.
Nope.
You guys have no clue how long we've been talking about this.
31 seconds. All right, y'all. It's been another episode of You Alive.
You Alive.
We talk about KD making the 3-point on the corner. Bam didn't give his change back. I mean, whatever it is. But we all know KD's a little sensitive to a certain situation.
Yeah, we'll leave it at that.
Yeah, we'll leave it at that. We talk about Texas and the new educational law or program that they got going down in Texas on shit that they're not going to teach no more. We talk about that bullshit. And what we talk about is love enough.
Is love enough?
Is love enough? Very females important. Definitely give us
a conversation input. To be continued.
Yes.
And that's listen, what I'm gonna say. we will take all opinions.
Oh yes, shoot it. Please. Shoot all that.
We'll take pushback too.
We know that we might be wrong.
We might be wrong for sure.
We know there are some slighted people out there. Yes. We know there are some broken hearts out there.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all.
Yes.
Come on. But yeah. Anyway, Maury. Sorry.
But you can catch me on Josh_Will15 on the Snapchat. IG J_Will R6 on the IG, man. Catch one there, man. Hey, Sir D, man, where can you find you at, bro?
Hey, you can find all my social media at Sir D's on my Snapchat, my Instagram, my Facebook. Make sure you give your boy a follow, like, comment on some shit. I'm there posting memes, acting the motherfucker. But we also have a Facebook and Instagram for ULI, so look us up on there if you want to drop us some topics to discuss or give us feedback. Maybe you hate our setup or our alcohol. Let us fucking know.
Yeah, let us know what's up. Brian, man, where can you find you at, bro?
You can find me on Twitter. Troll me, at BDana24. If you want to do that. If you don't, you can find me at Your Game Name's Lame, a.k.a.
Gamanama Slama.
Your Gamanama Slama. I can't get away from it.
You can.
Those are right now my two main venues. Honestly, Twitter's not my main venue. Yeah. But that's okay.
He won't use it.
That's okay. I'm trying to find out the place where I can just poke you just right.
And when I do,
it's going to be a problem. But, until then, that's it.
Man, you get on Buzzsprout. problem. We got the iTunes cracking. Free download for iTunes, too. We can catch on that motherfucker. You got IG.
Drop us a review.
Facebook, man. We're on YouTube, man. You can definitely catch on every single social media.
We got merch.
We got merch.
Yeah, plug us.
If you like clothing, sweats, sweaters, hats, whatever you want to do, we got the fucking merchandise on our 805ENT.
And if you're worried about how it looks, go to 805ent.com, spelled like it sounds, and you can check out the merch for yourself. We're going to let you know right now, it's pretty fly. It's simple. It's simple, it's easy, and it looks
fly
good.
As shit.
And speaking of our merch, the guy who designed it, he's not here in the studio with us, but follow him at C-Boy Designs Instagram.
Yes, he got some good shit for y'all,
my nigga do graphics, he do flyers, t-shirts, artistic nigga, bro. Whatever, website design.
Hit him up. He'll give you a quote. He's reasonable.
Yes.
Hit us up, man. Yes, we trying to do big things out here.
Yeah,
man.
We appreciate everyone being following us from day one.
Thank you.
Liking, subscribing, downloading everything. We had some people downloading the first episode, bro.
Yeah.
We appreciate y'all. We appreciate y'all for show.
Yes.
We're going to do Jamaica 2021. We're going to get a date set. We'll let you know on the dates. If you got your passport. Jamaica's gonna be next year for sure. We're gonna do some different for Jamaica. But
he a lie. You a lie. To get the gap.
What? I called you a lie in the outro. Look at that. It's the first time for everything.
What you call you a lie?
Jesus Christ.
Jamaica 2022.
Oh,
wow. I said 2021. Huh?
Oh, God.
Boom. And I want a shot,
what's
nigga.
What's the penalty?
Damn.
I want a shot, boy.
Oh, all right.
In the outro.
On the way out. On the way out.
For continuity, you got to do it on.
Look at Maury's face. This is terrible. This is awful.
Damn it.
This is awful.
You know what a motherfucker meant.
Nah, you a lie.
God damn it.
But he was counting twos last episode, nigga. You a lie.
Oh, shit. But y'all, man, catch on every social media platform. We appreciate everyone been liking, watching, subscribing, man. Keep it up. We're only going to get better from this shit, y'all. So definitely stay in tune with us, bro. We'll catch y'all next week. You alive.
You alive. But we can't turn off these cameras.
Until
we
can't. Continuity.
Continuity. You got to know, bro. You should have known. It wasn't going to happen.
I'm going to get his face.
Oh, we got to take the one shot. Look. Oh.
Get his face. All right,
man. Look, man, you know this tagline, bro. You can't say continuity and not do it. You gotta keep going.
I want to
Come on, brother.
Go ahead, man.
Come
it's okay. On, it's okay. We here for you, man. We gonna support you through the show.
I want it. Next episode, I'm on no ass, nigga. I'm on your ass. No one else. I was your fuck.
That's all right because I won twice last time.
Hey, America, know this. Next week, I'm on his ass for sure.
This is a spirit. This is the spirit of it right here. This is how rivalries are formed.
I can't believe I said that shit, bro.
After last episode, we're in the deuce. Yeah, you can't do that. I saw it. I watched it, bro. Look. Party foul. That's another shot.
I put it on purpose.
That's
way too much.
That's not even
cool. That's all good. Yeah, that's funny. Oh, man. Okay.
Continuity.
No, we at the end of a long episode. This is what happens when you get fatigued at the end of a long
episode. Okay.
Continuity.
So,
stay on your toes.
I'm going to be soon next week.
Watch yourself. Watch yourself.
Look, I'm going to be soon next week.
Hey.
It's gonna be good.
I be petty.
Bring it on.
Every single thing that you say, I'm gonna bring it on.
I don't think you said that right. Did you add a period of anything?
Bring it on.
Yeah.
You alive.
Yeah. Did you bear a motherfucking comma
about
that and?
There's an apostrophe in A.
Bring it on.
This is a very long outro. Take that shot so we can get the fuck out of here.
Outro,
right.
This is you alive, and we out. Continuity.